Hi everybody. Today I'd like to talk about file naming. No matter how crazy the name of a file may look like, don't ever change it. The client may have a whole different system on how to name their files, and you do not want to create chaos in that system. So if you don't work with a CAD tool, the best thing you can do is to save a copy of that file and add a little something for them to differentiate between the original and your translation. For example, if I receive a file named contract 012345.doc, I could save it as contract 012345-ptbr.doc. That PTBR means that it's in Portuguese and that it can be used in Brazil. Now, you cannot add letters out of the blue. You have to use something called ISO code. I'm sure you've heard about ISO standards, and there are ISO standards for language names. First of all, look for your target language, and then you notice that on the ISO table they have options with two letters or three letters. The three letters usually represent the name of a language according to how it's said in English. So, for example, Spanish is S-P-A and Swedish is S-W-E. Now, those two little letters, they represent the name of a language according how to it is said in that language. So, Spanish or Español would be E-S and Swedish or Svenska would be S-V. And when we have a language that is spoken in several countries, there are two little letters that can also represent the name of a country where the language is spoken. So, for example, I only translate into Brazilian Portuguese. So I put a BR next to the PT to indicate that my translation is from Brazil. My colleague from Portugal would add PT next to the PT, meaning that it's Portuguese from Portugal. So what are the takeaway lessons here? First, don't change the name of a file. Second, don't create a new name for your file. Third, look up the ISO standards for language codes and use your target language at the end of a file name. I know it may sound obvious, but don't ever forget to add your language combinations to your resume and to your business cards. I lost track of how many times I get a resume and there's no mention whatsoever of the language combination a person works in. Also, try to spell it out, just in case your potential client is not part of the language industry and isn't familiar with those ISO codes. So, for example, you can put English into Portuguese, Spanish into English. Many of us tend to use those symbols for more than or less than to indicate the direction in which we work. But if someone is not part of the translation industry, they may not get it. They just see English and Spanish and may assume that you work both directions, when it may not be true. So keep it simple and make it easy for people who may hire your services and put it right there on your resume, on your business card, on your website, wherever you advertise your services, that you work from this language into that language. Okay? Sounds obvious, right?
É incrível como não passa avião aqui o dia inteiro, é só ligar a câmera e pronto. Tô sobrevoando aqui a casa.